Dear colleagues, all over the world, wherever you are, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. It is a pleasure for me to present a work that was done by the Argentine Regulatory Authority together with the International Atomic Energy Agency, a work proposing some suggestions for solving the problem of radioactivity in goods supplied for public consumption or use. We propose some ideas towards an international harmonized regulatory framework. Thank you, Foliripa, for giving us this opportunity to share with our colleagues all over the world these ideas. For the objective of this presentation is just to submit this paper, to present this paper that was done by these two organizations. And the content of my presentation will include the background, something about semantic and terminology, what is the current situation, views from the states, and one decalogue of recommendations, 10 recommendations to go ahead, one epilogue. The background, on September 2015, the Regulatory Authority of Argentina and the agency agreed on practical arrangements, setting forth the framework for cooperation between us, and one relevant activity agreed to be pursued was the development and publication of an harmonized approach for managing radionuclide activity concentration in food, drinking water, and non-food commodities. This was an initiative of Miroslav Pinak, which is the head of the section in the IAEA. He has a very good ideas in this respect. And a result of this arrangement, the document was published and it's freely available and displayed in the web. You can download the document and see it by yourself. This is the head, the cover of the document, and was published in January 2019. There were several authors, but the agency main co-author is Tony Corgan. You know, he's very well known and he's in this Congress. He's the head of the Radiation Protection Unit. And the agency co-author is the head of our laboratories in ESEIS in Argentina, Analia Canova, who is very well known working in this area in many projects. The purpose of the documents is suggesting simply an approach for managing radionuclide in goods, supply for public consumption and use. And the current approach we understand is complex and contain inconsistencies and incoherences. And for that reason, we are proposing some changes. There is, we believe, an urgent need for a consistent approach that is simple to use and understand. There were many problems in this respect. The proposed way forward is an encompassing definition of good, generic available for public consumption and use. The definition now is very confusing. Abandoning the dosimetric quantities as controlling criteria and relying on the activity quantities. The basic questions to be addressed is whether the differentiation between goods that contain radionuclides artificially added and those presenting naturally, we should do that. Between goods that are consumed and items that are used, two different things. Those who are considered edible and those who are not. Those which are consumed and preferably by given sex or age, or should be that differentiation as it is now. And whether the goods are incorporating radionuclide from diverse initial exposure situations, as appear in our standard. These are basic questions. Because radionuclide consumer goods could already be present in the environment and from there reach the good existing situations, or be there to an authorized discharge, this is a planning situation, and be the result of a non-anticipated situation, emergency situation. Currently, these situations are subject to different regulatory approaches. We should treat goods differently. Let's go to semantic and terminology. There are words causing particular confusion. One was commodities. I personally have introduced that word in the agency glossary and that was one of the biggest mistakes. Commodities is not translatable and nobody understands what it really means. consumer product will be understandable, but unfortunately, the agency has used consumer product for products to which activity is added on purpose. There are very few of them now. The light of some cars. And the word contamination. This word is terrible. People don't understand how we can say the contamination is low. People is contaminated or not contaminated is a word that we should avoid to use. This document proposal is to use the word consumer good. We discuss this with people in the agency a lot, and this is translatable and include any merchandise, edible, non-edible product, material, good article, everything that is supplied for public consumption or use. Contamination is particularly unhelpful for consumer goods, in which the general content of radioactive substance is low. The use of this term is discouraged, and we will make that very clear. What is the current situation? Well, the current situation is the regulatory control of consumer goods is not straightforward. Some international agreements exist, as you know very well, but they are incoherent and inconsistent. Sorry. The Codex Alimentarius is one, the guideline for drinking water quality is another, the agency criteria for non-edible consumers is another, but there are incoherences. I mentioned this several times. In drinking liquid, for instance, you have a value for cesium from WHO for water, but Coca-Cola is supposed to be regulated by the Codex and the value is different. For non-edible versus edible is the same. You have a value for rice, the Codex, but if you make rice paper, then the value is lower and people cannot understand that. Therefore, there are a lot of incoherences. There is a problem of applicability. Is food any edible consumer good? Does food include drinks, for instance? Is water as edible as food? And if so, why food and water are regulated differently? Should edibles that people eat for pleasure or vice, not for nutrition, be out of the food regulation? Not clear. An understanding of food has cultural connotations. Substances that are edible in some cultures are considered unedible in others. What do we do? The question of edibility is very interesting. For a good to be food, it should be edible. But the definition of edibility is cultural. Look at the internals of a cow. In some countries, it's a gourmet dish. In some other countries, they are used for guitar chord. Is food or is not food? The meaning of water, well, we believe that water is very clear. The WHO in English talk about drinking water. What is drinking water? It's translated as potable water. It's subtle difference. Is tap water? Probably, because there are separate regulations for packet drinking water. And the more surprising thing is that there is a separate regulation for natural mineral waters. And in this regulation, there are no limits of activity. You can put all the activity that you like if it is natural. And as you know, there are some natural mineral water which are very rich in radium, among others, which is not a very nice nuclide. The dosimetric approach, well, becquerels are factual. They can be measured and regulated. Microsieverts, as appear in some regulations, are conjectural. They cannot be regulated. You cannot measure a microsievert. You can calculate with any accuracy a microsievert. Therefore, let's talk on becquerels. Exposure situations. Well, you know that in our regulation, we have planned emergency and existing exposure situation. Now, radiation exposure from a consumer good does not fall neatly in any of these situations. Consumers and users of consumer goods are not interested in the exposure situation that originated the presence of radioactivity, or whether the product is safe or not. They are not interested in coming from an accident, from here, from there. They said this is safe or not. For it's not really, the situation is not tailored to consumer goods. It is suggested that this categorization should not be used for considering the need for controlling consumer goods. View from states. We took account of view from state. In March 2017, we called to Buenos Aires a workshop of all the states, many states, and then the workshop was repeated by the agency in Xi'an in China in 2018, and we collected a lot of views from this meeting, for we know what the preoccupation of the states are. With this, we create a decalogue of recommendations. First, that the term be used as commodities and consumer products that be replaced by the term consumer goods, defined as it shows there, include merchandise, edible, non-edible, etc., etc. And consumer products be retained for the definition that appear in the DGC glossary. The use of third contamination should be avoided when referring to consumer goods. For instance, we can use the present radionuclide in consumer goods, something like that. But not contamination. People have a very bad understanding of the word contamination, which have a religious connotation, by the way. The quantity to be used for regulating consumer goods is the activity or relative. And its derivative, activity per unit volume, per unit weight, per unit surface, whatever. It's unreasonable to use dosimetric quantities. Four, the presence of radionuclides in consumer goods should be regulated regardless of the origin of the radionuclide, because radiation risks are independent of the origin of the activity. Specifically, consumer goods containing natural occurring radionuclides and those containing artificial nuclides should regulate using the same criteria. People, there are no difference for the damage that they can do to people. Five, the amount of natural radionuclides present in wider level available consumer goods could serve as a good indicator of acceptable level of radioactivity of any origin in consumer goods. People are eating many products with radioactivity. Why not use that as a reference? Six, due to the ubiquity and the general global distribution of consumer goods, national framework should be coherent and consistent with consensual international guidance established by governing bodies of relevant international intergovernmental organizations. The national regulation really doesn't serve any purpose, just to create confusion and fight between countries. Seven, the regulation of consumer goods should be neither be based on the special situation from which they are derived, planned emergency existing, nor on the type of exposure being incurred, occupation or public. Namely, all those affected by consumer goods should be considered members of the public undergoing an exposure situation without qualification. Eight, the control criteria for consumer goods should take into account conflicting views on edibility. We have to solve that problem, whether something is a food or not a food. We need to discuss that because this is a serious problem. Nine, activity levels in consumer goods that are considered safe for women and children should be used as a main criteria, which should be established based on consideration of a national person representative of those at higher risk. Because if we introduce difference among gender or age, as happened now, this is very difficult to implement. For if children and women are more sensitive, let's use their numbers. 10, national system of controlling consumer goods could be framed on the following criteria. States could exclude from regulations some consumer goods. For instance, due to the dose, due to potassium 40, we cannot control bananas or things like that. And regulations, in addition, should establish level of radioactivity under which consumer goods can be exempted. By whom? By the regulator. My epilogue. It is expected that the suggestion here will be helpful for clarifying a number of issues relative to the control of radioactivity in consumer goods. Until now, these issues have not been properly resolved and have been the subject of different interpretations and confusion. It is essential that the relevant intergovernmental international bodies, like the IAEA, WHO, etc., address and resolve the many issues referred to here above. This is the document downloaded from the web. Look on it, and I hope that this will be a new starting for a new approach for resolving this old problem of good supply for public consumption and good. There are even resolutions of the General Conference of the agency. We could not solve properly this problem today, and it's a mea culpa that we have to have. Thank you very much. Here you have my data, and certainly you can take from there. I can provide to you all the information that I have used here. Thank you very much, and have a good time, and care of yourself. Thank you.